Hey guys, welcome to DevTech Finance, and here's another video on assets. So let's get started. An asset is a property or resource having monetary value which is capable of producing some future economic benefit owned by an individual or entity. So, you know, this is the basic definition which you would find everywhere on the browsers. And what it actually means is that asset could be any property like building or anything, or it could be any resource or any stock, any bond, any financial asset, whatever you are owning, which is having some kind of monetary value in itself and which is able to generate income for you, which is able to generate a source of cash flows for you. So this is what this definition is talking about. Either you see it as an individual or you talk it as a corporate, as an institution. Everywhere you would observe that you are engrossed into building assets. And why is that? Because assets are generating a source of income for you. Simply stated, assets represent the value of ownership or possession that can be converted into cash. In financial accounting concept, assets are resources that can generate cash flows. So obviously, when we are talking about cash flows, we are talking about cash inflows. One that is coming inside your pocket, one that is coming to you. So cash inflows are being generated through assets owned by the business. Now, in the balance sheet of a firm, which records all the current as well as non-current assets owned by the firm, and it is one of the most important financial statements prepared by any of the entity or institution, and this is why the assets become so important, because assets is always mentioned in the balance sheet. It is representing how many assets is actually the institution owning, because that is a representative of the future income which would be generated to the business and which would result into the growth and stability and a long-term position of the business. So, you know, there is also a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad, which describes asset in a very simpler manner. And that book is written by Robert Kiyosaki. I would recommend you all to go through that book to understand asset in a very simpler manner in terms of your own personal finance. How can you build assets? And whatever you are considering as an asset, whether it is or it is not an asset for you. So, according to that book, you know, when you are owning a building, most of the middle class families feel that when we are having our own home, our own house, that is an asset for us. But that's not actually an asset, that's a liability, because you have paid to build that and that's not generating a source of regular income for you. So when you are renting out your property, that would become an asset because that would generate an income for you on a regular basis. So this is how you can differentiate between asset and liability, and how you could convert your liability into assets also. So I would recommend you all to go through that book. That's a very nice book. And asset in a simpler manner is one that would generate income for you. Now let's have a look at the classification of assets. Now we are talking in terms of accounting, so we would see how the assets are classified. So it is on the basis of convertibility in current assets and as fixed assets on the basis of fiscal existence. It is divided as tangible assets and intangible assets, and on the basis of uses, it is divided as operating assets and non-operating assets. So this is how assets can be classified: on the basis of convertibility, on the basis of fiscal existence, on the basis of its uses. So one by one, we would go through all these classification of assets. So starting with the current assets. Current assets are short-term economic resources that are expected to be converted into cash within 1 year. So when we are talking about current assets, these are the assets which can be converted into cash within 1 year period of time. So these are most liquid assets. We often define current assets as liquid assets because they are easily convertible. So if you need cash after 1 month or 2 months, so you can depend on these current assets to run your business smoothly or efficiently. So some of the examples are like stock, inventories, prepaid expenses, marketable securities, short-term investments which you have made, that is within 1 year, or the bank balances, the debtors which has been created, and who are these debtors to whom you have actually supplied the finished goods, or you have provided the service but not yet get the payment. So these debtors would be making the payment in near future. So these are also considered as current assets. Then there are fixed deposits. So you can see stock, inventory, prepaid expense, all these things. What is the common thing in all these examples? These all are current assets because these are convertible within a shorter period of time. Let's talk about the fixed assets. These assets are long-term resources that cannot be easily converted into cash. Instead, are utilized to generate economic benefits for longer period of time. So yeah, obviously you can convert fixed assets into cash as well, but that would take a longer period of time. You would have to sell that assets, and then the whole procedure would take a longer period of time, and it would generally not be within 1 year. It would take more than that period of time. So and you know why is that happening? Because fixed assets are usually purchased, usually bought for a longer period of economic benefits to be generated out of it, for a longer period of income to be generated out of it. So whether we are talking about land, building, plant and equipment, furniture, machinery, all these assets are considered as fixed assets, and these assets are used in business. But these assets are not the one, not among those assets which are just there for a lesser period of time. Whether you talk about land, whether you talk about machines that are kept for approx more than 5 years of time, because that need to be utilized. That need to be utilized for a continuous production process, for a continuous income generation for your business. This is also referred as non-current assets or long-term assets. Coming to classification of assets on the basis of physical existence. So it may be classified as tangible assets. Now, what is a tangible asset? It is an asset that has a physical form. It could be either fixed or current. So this is one way of classification. Here, all we are talking about the same assets, but we are seeing how it can be classified into different ways. So first we saw that how was it classified on the basis of its convertibility, on the basis of its long-term and short-term period of time in which it could be liquidated. Now we are seeing on the basis of its physical existence. So tangible assets are those which are having a physical form. So it could be land, building, furniture, plant and equipment, inventory, or cash. Anything which you could see, which you could hold, which is having a physical appearance would be classified as tangible assets. Now let's see what is intangible assets then. An intangible asset is an asset that is not physical in nature. So whether we talk about goodwill, patent, copyright, franchisee agreement, or trademark, all these assets are very valuable for business because they kind of build a market reputation of the business. They create a brand name of the business. But you know what? The common thing is that they are intangible in nature. They are not having any physical existence. They are just there indicating a growth of the business, a successful business which has been building a reputation in the market, because of which it has got its goodwill, because of which it has been able to get a copyright for its products, a trademark, a patent. So these are classified as intangible assets. Let's move forward and have a look at how are assets classified on the basis of its uses. So it could be operating assets. And what is operating assets? These are the assets required for day-to-day business transactions. These assets are used in core production process, and it could be like cash, bank balance, inventories, or materials, all those things. So operating assets are being utilized in the production process of the business, in the operational activities of the business. So whether the cash is being utilized to buy the raw materials, or whether the stock is being utilized to be further converted into finished products, all these would be considered as operating assets. Then what would be non-operating assets? These are the assets owned by business but not used in daily operational activity. Instead, are held for selling or using them in future. So these non-operating assets can provide diversification and act as a financial support. So, you know, non-operating assets are not being used in the direct business process, in the direct production process or operational activity of the business. But these are assets held by the business so that it can be used in future whenever it is required. For example, any investment that has been made by a business in any other company in stocks or bonds, now that would be considered as an asset for the business. But that is not an operating asset because that is not being utilized in the production process. Rather, those investments are being held by the business so that the cash could be generated in the future period of time and it could be availed as and when required by the business to maintain its efficiency and effectiveness in the market. So this was all about this video on assets. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video. Do like and share my videos and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Dev Take Finance. Thank you all.